I feel so bad about expelling them, but what else was I going to do? I mean, I have to protect the other children.
That's right. Elizabeth, Chad and Earl had a choice. They could have admitted to what they did and apologized for it.
But they didn't.
You talked to their father. Now it's up to him.
Any news in this morning's paper?
Nothing about the Northern Territories. But Mrs. Wheeler's heifer took first prize in the county fair.
That's my kind of news. I could dearly use a cup of tea.
Rosemary, are you okay?
What happened? Why is the mercantile in the middle of the street? It's not.
Well, it certainly seems that way. And let me just say, driving a car is far more complicated than riding a horse.
Wait a minute. Are you saying that you almost hit the mercantile with Lee's new car?
When did you learn how to drive?
Lee's giving me lessons.
Oh, and he is not going to be one bit pleased when he finds out I almost hit the mercantile and a wagon. And Katie Brayman's chickens.
The town council really needs to think about making the streets wider.
Sweetheart, can I talk to you for a minute?
I'll go get the tea.
I'll help.
Before you say anything, I want you to know it wasn't my fault.
Oh, really? So the car forced you to get behind the wheel, is that it?
Lee Coulter, I do not have to do everything you tell me to do. You are not my boss.
Maybe I should be.
Here we go. You take that back right now. Right this instant.
No.
All right. Then that's it. I'm going to stay at Elizabeth's until you come to your senses.
You are?
Yes, I am.
Fine. You do that.
Fine. I will.